Hello students, welcome to Marine Engineering Tutorials. I am Atul Kumar Gupta and back with a new tutorial. Presently we are studying marine boilers. Today we have fifth lecture on marine boilers and the subject is classification of boilers. Marine boilers can be classified in various ways which will be discussed in the following slides. The most important basis of their classification is whether it is water tube or smoke tube boiler. Their advantages and limitations are also being discussed to understand the boilers elaborately. Boilers can be classified in several ways which we will discuss in the following slides. First of all, let's see the first method of classification. This is regarding the fluid flow. In smoke tube boilers, smoke or flue gases passes through the tubes which heat up the surrounding water. On the other hand, in water tube boilers, tubes carry water and steam which are heated by the flue gases flowing across them. Steam ships are equipped with water tube boilers, whereas motor vessels may have smoke or water tube boilers. The second is internally or externally fired boilers. Internally fired boilers have a furnace in which the fuel is burnt to heat up the water. Most of the boilers fall into this category. However, exhaust gas boilers on motor vessels which use the waste heat of engine exhaust fall into the category of externally fired boilers. Steam ships are equipped with oil fired boilers, whereas motor vessel, in addition to the oil fired boiler, have an exhaust gas boiler or a composite boiler also. Third is on the basis of oil boiler pressure. Boilers below 32 bar pressure are called low pressure boilers and above 32 bar are called high pressure boilers. Steam ships are equipped with high pressure boilers, whereas motor vessels are low pressure boilers. The next is natural or forced circulation of water. Usually, all internally or oil-fired boilers have natural circulation of water caused by temperature difference. Those exhaust gas boilers on the motor vessels, which do not have their own reservoir of water and steam, are called forced circulation boiler, as water from the internally fired boiler is circulated through the heating coil using a pump. Similarly, supercritical steam generators also fall in the category of forced circulation boilers. In the subsequent slide, we'll see some more ways. Now we have vertical or horizontal boilers. This classification is on the basis of shell axis, whether vertical or horizontal. High pressure water tube boilers with large evaporation rate used on the steam ships are horizontal design with two or more drums. On the other hand, smoke tube boilers with single drum used on the motor vessels are of vertical design. Then stationary marine or locomotive boilers. As the name suggests, it is simple to classify them. Boilers used on the land are called stationary. Those used on the ships are called marine, and locomotive boilers were used on earlier railway. Then as per the number of drum, single or multiple drum, smoke tube boilers are of single drum design, whereas water tube boiler may have two or more drums. According to the gas flow, whether single or multipass, smoke tube boilers may have single or multipass design of the gas flow, but water tube boilers have single pass design. So let's see some more ways of boiler classification. Now we have natural or forced draft, which means combustion air in most of the boilers is supplied with a forced draft fan. Although very small boilers may have a natural draft, very large boiler may have both forced and induced draft fans. Then as per the heat source, we can classify the boilers. Large boiler in power plants use solid fuel, which is pulverized coal. Most of the marine boilers use liquid fuel, although natural gas is gaining popularity due to strict emission rules. Some of the land-based boilers and the most of the submarines, they use nuclear fuel. And the waste heat recovery boilers on the motor vessels use exhaust gas of the main engine. Some motor vessels operating in the emission control area also use LNG fuel. Then as per the steam evaporation, whether single or dual, most of the boilers have single evaporation, but when risk of the feed water contamination is high, double evaporation may be preferred. Then lastly, we can classify the boiler as per material of construction. Shell of the modern boiler is constructed from the steel, although very early boilers were made of wrought iron. Similarly, the modern vessels have all welded construction, whereas earlier boilers had riveted construction. So now we will see the differences between smoke tube and water tube boilers. We will compare the smoke tube and water tube boilers on the following basis. First is fluid passing through the tubes. Smoke tube boilers carry smoke or flue gases in the tubes, which heat up the surrounding water, whereas water tube boilers carry water and steam in the tubes, which is heated by the flue gases flowing over the tubes. The next is weight of the boiler. Smoke tube boiler is 3 times heavier for the same heating surface area, whereas water tube boiler is lighter. Thus, there is a reduction in the dead weight. Third is on the basis of pressure in the boiler. Smoke tube boiler is used for low and medium pressures and has low efficiency, whereas water tube boiler is used for medium and high pressure and has higher plant efficiency. Then the efficiency of combustion. Smoke tube boiler has less efficient combustion due to restricted size of the furnace surrounded by water, as large furnace will have more wall thickness of the furnace, which reduces heat transfer. Combustion in the water tube boiler is more efficient and there is no restriction in the size of the furnace. than as per the circulation of water. Smoke tube boiler has poor water circulation due to large amount of the water, which causes high risk of thermal stressing. Whereas water tube boiler has better water circulation due to small amount of water, which reduces risk of thermal stressing. So in the subsequent slide, we will see some more differences. As per the evaporation rate, we can classify the boilers. Smoke tube boilers take longer time to raise the steam due to large quantity of water and large diameter of the tubes, whereas water tube boilers raise the steam faster due to small quantity of water and small diameter of tubes. As per the space requirement, smoke tube boilers occupy more space, whereas water tube boilers provide saving in the space for the same heating surface area. As per the susceptibility to deformation, smoke tube boiler's furnace is more susceptible to deformation as it is exposed to radiant heat in the compact space, and furnace of the water tube boiler are protected from intense heat and thus provide wider safety margins. As per the attachment of the tube, large diameter tubes of the smoke tube boilers are attached by welding, whereas small diameter and thin tubes used in the water tube boilers are easier to bend, expand and bell mount. And lastly, on the basis of quantity and quality of water required, smoke tube boiler has large quantity of water due to which it takes longer time to raise steam and is less efficient. On the other hand, water tube boiler are more efficient because they contain less water and can raise the steam faster. Due to large quantity of reserve water, smoke tube boiler has low risk of water shortage, whereas water tube boiler may suffer from major damage when run dry during operation. Thus, efficient water level control is required. In smoke tube boiler, raw feed water may be used if distilled water is not available, whereas in water tube boiler, only distilled water should be used. So in this lecture, we have covered the classification of boilers and differences between smoke tube and water tube boilers. This book is written by me and covers all the topics as per Indian Maritime University syllabus. It clarifies the concepts with simple illustrations. This book also provides answers to all the questions which have appeared in the examination conducted by Indian Maritime University. This book can help the students in preparing for the exam and also for working on the ship's boiler safely. Hope you have liked the lecture. You can write your feedback in the comment box. If you have liked the tutorial, you can share with your friends. You may subscribe to the channel for getting notification about the new tutorials. I'll be back with a new lecture shortly. Thanks for watching the tutorial till the end.